Good morning children, this is third standard English class. Today I am going to show you the blocks which you have to learn for summative assessment. These are the blocks you have to learn for your summative assessment. Block 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8 and 9. Once again I am repeating children. Block 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8 and 9. In that, what are the topics? I'll just show you. In block 1, you have describing a person, using is or am or describing a character. In block 2, you have adjectives. Adjectives means nothing but describing words. And descriptive writing. See the picture and write what is happening. You may get any picture and you have to see and write what is happening over there. Now block 3, Ovaltine, meanings you have to learn, present tense verbs you have to learn, sequencing the events using order words like first, then, next, after that and finally. So we have to write the events using the order words. In block 4, you have subject and verb agreement. So in subject and verb agreement, see like this. Here in block 4 practice question, here the subjects they have given and no predicates. How did you write these predicates? By seeing the story. Like that you may get the story and you have to write missing subject to the predicate and missing predicate to the subject. That is subject and verb agreement. And writing a story, write the story with the given clues. You have to write the story, we will give you the clues. You have to write the story. This one, afterwards I'll explain you children. Now in block 5, you have to learn meanings, add ing to the given verbs. In block 7, past tense words. Block 8, you have to learn meanings, true or false. And in block 9, you have to learn common and proper nouns. Punctuation, using capital letters, full stop and question mark. Okay children, this is the portion, these are the blocks and the bits you have to learn. Now I told you in block 4, clues we'll give you and you have to write the story. One second children, I'll show you the picture. See children, for example I'm showing you the same picture, it won't come in the exam. So this is the picture. For this picture I have written some clues. What are the clues here? Dental hospital, boy, picture, toothache, sits, doctor, stands, check, tooth, comma, removed, feeling better, happy now. So these are the clues children. Dental hospital, boy, picture, toothache, sits, doctor, stands, check, tooth, removed, feeling better, happy now. So with these clues, you have to write the story, what is happening there. Now children, this is the story I have written by using these clues. So dental hospital, for that what I have written, it is a dental hospital. Boy, picture, see I have taken these two words and I wrote like the boy in the picture is having toothache. He sits in the chair and the doctor stands next to the boy to check. After that, he removed his tooth. The boy is feeling better. He is happy now. See children, dental hospital. See here how I used. You have to use these clues as it is happening, right? As it is happening over there. See, once again I am reading children. It is a dental hospital. The boy in the picture is having toothache. He sits in the chair and the doctor stands next to the boy to check his tooth. After that, he removed his tooth. द बॉय इज फीलिंग बेटर ही इज हैप्पी नाउ हाउ डिड आई राइट चिल्ड्रन बाय यूजिंग द क्लूज एंड ऑल्सो बाय सीइंग द पिक्चर आई हैव रिटन सो चिल्ड्रन लर्न ऑल दीज ब्लॉक्स फ्रॉम योर रीडर क्लास वर्क एंड वर्क बुक एंड रिमेंबर चिल्ड्रन वेन यू आर राइटिंग द आंसर्स डोंट फॉरगेट टू Use capital letters and full stop wherever necessary. Understood, children? After the sentence completes, you have to put full stop. When you are writing the sentence, you have to use the capital letter. Remember that punctuation. Don't forget that. Prepare well for your summative assessments. All the best, children. Thank you.